Okay, so I'm going to show you how to do some more constraints. When you go to my website, oops, this needs to be updated. There we go. You're going to make a new folder and you're going to call it constraints. And you're going to download these two parts in the constraints, and then you're going to make an assembly file and bring those parts into the assembly file. So these are what the parts look like. We've got a block with a hole in it and a cylinder that seems to be about the same size as the hole. So for the constraints, we've learned flush and mate already. So we could, mate these two surfaces, or we can make them flush to each other. So we did that a lot with our puzzle cube activity. But there are other constraints. For example, the insert constraint. We could insert this one inside, or excuse me, on the outside. That's called an opposed, or we can align it so that it's inside. So that's the insert constraint. We could also do a tangent constraint. So we could make it the outer edge tangent to that one, or we could have it on the inside. That's another one. We could also do on an angle. And this one is a little tricky. Sometimes I can't really get it to work. So let's try a 45 degree angle. And then I'm still learning how to use this one. So there's a way to change the angle to go in the other direction. And what I just did was not it. So maybe if we did like 180. Nope. Okay. That one needs some playing around with. So that was the angle. So we could click on the surface and the surface and change the angle. And so this time it changed this one. So something that we're also need to start doing is the first object that we place, we need to anchor that object so that for example, the block just moved. Maybe I don't want the block to move. I want the cylinder to move, or vice versa. So if we right click on the object, and then we're going to select ground. That's going to keep this one in place. So if I go to do another constraint, the cylinder should always be the one to move. Oops, I hit the wrong side there. So if we grounded the cylinder and ungrounded our block, then the opposite should happen. So there's a few other constraints that we're gonna eventually use for this motion constraint, or I'm sorry, the transitional constraint. We'll be using that one for our automata project. Play around with these, see if you can get the symmetry to work, and then the angle one. I obviously haven't figured out how to do that one well yet, so maybe you could help me figure that one out. Okay, and that is it.